Carl Dix. I'm down with the Revolutionary Communist Party, and I got an important message about the legacy of the Attica prison uprising more than 40 years ago today. We are men. We're not beasts, and we do not intend to be beaten and driven as such. This was the declaration issued by the men in Attica State Prison back in September of 1971, as they rose in the most powerful prison rebellion in U.S. history. The Attica brothers took guards as hostages and controlled the prison for 4 days, issuing demands that included an end to brutality, better conditions in the prison, and no reprisals against them for rising up. Their example of defiance electrified the whole country and the world. And the way in which the prisoners conducted themselves while they controlled the prison showed a glimpse of how the world could be different. They overcame differences between blacks and whites. They refused to back down in the face of threatened attacks by the state police. They shared what food and water they had amongst themselves and with their hostages. And no one took vengeance against the guards for the brutality that the guards had inflicted on them. The authorities had demonized the prisoners, calling them the worst of the worst. But the powers that be showed themselves to be the real murderers. On September 13th, then-Governor Nelson Rockefeller ordered the state police to assault the prison. 29 prisoners and 10 guards were murdered in that assault, all killed by the state police. Then the prisoners were stripped naked and subjected to unspeakable brutality. The rebellion was crushed, but the legacy of Attica lived on. The Attica brothers gave a generation of youth hope that things didn't have to be this way, and that people on the bottom of society could be part of changing the world. The cry Attica was heard wherever people rose in resistance to the system's attacks. Now today, 2.5 million people, more than five times as many as were in prison in 1971, are locked down in U.S. jails. 2.5 million people. That's more than any other country in the world. More than two-thirds of them are black or Latino. This is the result of a whole generation of youth having been criminalized by this system. In prison, they are subjected to conditions even more brutal than those that sparked the prisoners at Attica to rebel. After they're released from prison, they're treated like they're less than human. And I got to tell you, this racially targeted mass incarceration is a consequence of us not having made revolution in the 1960s. This system was rocked back on its heels by the powerful revolutionary movement of that time. And the system remembers that it was the struggle of black people that spearheaded that revolutionary movement. So today, as this country enforces conditions in the ghettos and barrios even more degrading and brutal than in the 1960s, it has unleashed its courts and its cops to trap black and Latino youth up in the criminal injustice system. That's why so many of our youth are in jail or on parole or saddled with criminal records. This system is enforcing a kind of counterinsurgency before the insurgency through warehousing people in prison. The authorities justify all this as what's needed to fight crime. They say that the people they have locked in their jails are the worst of the worst. They say that they pose a great danger to society and deserve to be locked away. But this is not true. It's the system that's criminal, not our youth. The legacy of Attica shows that people on the bottom, people who have been locked down and condemned as the worst of the worst, can stand up, can fight the power. And as they fight back, they can change themselves. Today, 40 years later, we must remember Attica and we must take up its legacy. We are human beings and we must refuse to accept to be being treated like animals. We must stand up and resist racially targeted mass incarceration and all the other shit that this system brings down on people. And as a revolutionary communist, I say that all the misery and brutality enforced on people here and around the world stems from the very way this capitalist system works. And it'll take revolution, getting rid of this system once and for all, and bringing into being a new system that serves our interest in its place to end all this madness. This kind of revolution is possible. It could be done. It's been done before, and even though power has been seized back where revolutions were made, we could go farther and do better because of the work that Bob Avakian has done to study the experience of previous revolutionary communist societies and to develop a new viable and desirable approach to making communist revolution. Now, it's not time to go all out to seize the power from those who rule over us, but it is time to step up the preparation for revolution. A big part of getting ready for revolution is fighting the power and transforming ourselves and others for revolution. So you got to get with us. You got to get with this. We will take to the streets on September 13th, next Tuesday, to mark the 40th anniversary of the Attica Rebellion. Attica means fight back will echo through the streets of Harlem. I have to say this to those of you who have experienced firsthand the misery, brutality, and inhumanity of this system's mass incarceration. Attica means fight back. Join us on the 13th. To those who have watched generations of sons, fathers, brothers, friends, and lovers be chewed up and spit out by the injustice system, I say Attica means fight back. Those who are just learning about the legacy of Attica and the present-day reality of mass incarceration, or maybe who knew about it but thought nothing could be done, I say Attica means fight back. Join us on September 13th in the streets of Harlem. Also come out on September 9th at Riverside Church at 6:30 p.m. because there's going to be a program titled Attica is All of Us. There's going to be Attica Brothers and others who speak there. Come out for that too. And if you see mass incarceration for the horrible injustice that it is, get in touch with the Stop Mass Incarceration Network. We're going to be building a fight to stop this outrage, starting with a day of stop, and frisk. That's going to be in October, in the days leading into the October 22nd National Day of Protest to Stop Police Brutality. Get in touch, get involved, and say no more to the bullshit that they enforce on us. And if you want to get in touch, the ways to do that are to email us at stopmassincarceration@ymail.com. That's stopmassincarceration, one word, at ymail.com. Or call us at a toll-free number, 866-841-9139, extension 2670. Attica means fight back. The capitalist system is the problem, and revolution is the solution. Get with us, sisters and brothers.